My name is Patrick Gasda. I'm a postdoc at Los Alamos National Laboratory, and I study the geochemistry and astrobiology of Mars. Recently, we found, for the first time, boron on Mars in Gale Crater with the NASA Curiosity rover. So boron is an element, and it's very water-soluble, so it's important because boron can tell us about the surface and subsurface water activity on ancient Mars. In Gale Crater, there was a lake, and after this lake disappeared, the water retreated into the subsurface, and we had this groundwater system. Boron, being this element that's very water-soluble, is in the groundwater, and after that groundwater disappears, you're left with these calcium sulfate veins with boron in them. This groundwater was habitable because A, it was liquid, and where we find liquid water on the Earth, we tend to find life. And B, we know from many other studies of this type of groundwater that it had to have been warm, and the boron tells us that it probably wasn't overly acidic or overly alkaline. So regular types of organisms could live there, like bacteria. So we use the ChemCam instrument, which was built here at Los Alamos in collaboration with the French Space Agency. We take a laser, we fire at a target nearby, and those elements get excited. When those elements are excited, they emit light. And when we look at that light, we can see that there's boron and all the other elements in there. What we understand is the order of events, but not necessarily the timing of these geological events. So we know that Gale Crater formed during a time when Mars was wet, and then a lake formed inside of the crater. Later, that lake disappeared, and you have the total burial of the crater by sediments. This discovery, along with others, has helped us extend the timescale of habitability of Mars. Los Alamos National Laboratory has had a long history of building and operating instruments for space missions, and these include past, present, and future Mars missions.